Have you ever wanted to make stylized lights? This low-poly light effect is made by using meshes to simulate light, and that can give your game that unique feel you're looking for. So follow along as we enhance our scene and improve its lights. Here's the scene we are going to use. We got a character holding a torch and some objects. First, create a mesh instance 3D that will become our light. Then create a new sphere mesh. This is going to be our light area. So let's set its starting size to be 2 for the radius and 4 for the height. And to really give that low poly style, you'll change the segments to 10 and the rings to 6. This sphere represents the light, and everything that is inside, you'll be giving that light effect. Next, create the override material for the mesh. And here, set the transparency to alpha, the depth brow to never, and the shading to unshaded. Then, take the albedo color and set the alpha to 0 to make it transparent. Finally, enable custom stencil and check the right depth fail with the reference of 1. The stencil is just an image we draw to and use it later to mask objects. And by writing the depth fail to the stencil, we are taking all the parts of the sphere that is occluded by other objects and saving that shape to the stencil. This will become important soon. And now for the real light effect, create a new pass material and set the cool mode to front, so we can only see the back faces, and the shading to unshaded. Then make the depth test inverted, and this will make the sphere only render where it is behind objects, which is exactly what we want. Now, if we just set the transparency to alpha and lower the albedo transparency, we can highlight the area and give the impression it is a light. But there is a better way to do that, so let's reset the color and change the blend mode to multiply instead. Then take the color and increase its intensity to create an HDR color. Now the colors will blend nicely and give us a much better light effect, which also works with any color. But here's the problem. Because we inverted the depth testing, the light will now show up even when it's behind objects, which is exactly why we create the stencil copy of that in the first material. So first, enable transparency back again, and enable custom stencil. This time, we are going to use the read operation and the compare flag of not equal, but it is not working yet. That is because the order of objects rendered matters when dealing with stencils. We need to make sure the read stencils are rendered after the right ones. So let's increase the render priority of the material to 1, as higher numbers render later. And now it works. We have our light effect properly masked to only show up behind objects, and we can move it around to see it working. So let's rename this stencil light and put it inside the torch so it follows the player around. And to improve the effect, we can change the scene lights to give it a more dark feeling. Here, I'll decrease the sky contribution even more, and also decrease the directional light, as well as play around with its colors. A bit better, but also too dark and too bland. So to improve this, we can fuse our fake lights with real lights by adding an omni light to the torch. And let's decrease its energy to keep things feeling dark. And that's better. But the light is making the helmet a bit too bright, so we can turn the specular to 0 to remove those highlight spots. And now we have a cool light effect working, but we still have a problem to solve. So here, I've added another stencil light. Let's duplicate it and see what happens. And there's our problem. We get some strange artifacts when the stencil zone clips. One light mesh is affecting the other, so let's see how we can get multiple lights working out. To fix that, let's open the material and create yet another next pass material. And make sure the render priority is higher than the last one. Disable depth test, enable alpha, and make it transparent. And now, we are going to use this to clear the stencil, so the next light can work with a clean state. So enable custom stencil, check the right operation, and change the reference to 0, to reset the stencil for that area. But for this to work, each of your lights will need to have a different incremental render priority. So select the other light, and choose Make Unique Recursive. Now we can change the second light without affecting the first one, and as the last light ended with the priority of 3, we'll change the materials on this one to be the priority of 4, 5, and 6. And there it is. The light stencils no longer affect each other. But you have to do this for each new light you create. So that's include the torch light. So let's repeat the same steps and increase the priority there too. But now we have multiple working lights we can use and move around. And if the setup annoys you, you can create a simple tool script to automatically change the priority for you when duplicating the light, which makes it much easier to create them. But that's it. Now you can create fake lights to give your games their unique feel. And as always, if you'd like to support me, you can get these project files and other experiments by supporting me on Patreon. I hope you liked this video, and until next time.